Welcome back, this traders, with another episode in the LA Rams franchise. It is week 8 and we're going to be playing our final away game of this away game period against the Minnesota Vikings, a team with a fantastic offense, a not so fantastic defense, but they're going to be giving us a run for the money nevertheless. We've got quite a few things to take care of this week. We have perfect chemistry, we've got a breakout player, so really excited to see who this will be. We've got players to negotiate, players to upgrade. We're going to choose the national scouting focus. We can take a look at the mock draft. So a lot of things going on. Let's take care of the quickest one. Cameron Jordan is available to play again. He's making a return. He's going to be the backup for George Karlaftis at the left edge position. All right, that wasn't too exciting, right? So let's head into perfect chemistry. You've been on a tear these past couple of games. I've seen stretches like this turn guys into the league's next superstar. You're on the right path, just keep doing what you're doing. That's the plan. My goal this year was taking my game to the next level. These last two games were just the beginning. Get your popcorn ready. All right. Wow, okay. We can get into superstar if we get 125 yards receiving against the Vikings. Okay. Touchdown multiplier again. Well, that is great. I mean, didn't expect it to go this quickly, but we're gonna try our darndest to upgrade him, of course. What's the breakout player here? Just wanted to say, really appreciate it involving me in the game last week. Gets boring out there. It's very nice. I don't know who you're talking about, so let's see who this is. Oh, okay. That's Tyquan Thornton. 3 touchdowns or 150 yards rushing or receiving. All right, so we're going to be focusing on Tyquan Thornton this week. That's for sure. What about players to negotiate? Cam Jordan, we covered that. He will not get a new contract, but we have two other important players for us that we're going to be taking care of now. Anthony Hines III and Ernest Jones, linebackers, both of them. We're going to give Anthony Hines, 5-year deal. He's my starter, so I do want to lock him down here. That is clear as day, but 7.18 mil is the impact here. Let's just go with what he's asking. All right, that's a good offer. Glad we got the deal done. I'm glad too. We got a super solid outside linebacker. He'll be heading into the higher 80s this season. So that's fantastic. What about Ernest Jones? He's my third midline backer. He is actually not that expensive. When you look at it, gonna give him a 5-year deal, maybe even a 6-year deal till he's 30. Just a 2.9 mil cap hit. All right, offer's perfect. So we've got both of them locked down. That is great. Who else will be wanting a new contract this year? We've got Logan Bruss, who I'm going to be giving the contract to, no questions asked. Bobby Brown, I want to lock down. Broderick Jones, I actually do want to sign him as well. But those don't look too crazy, actually. Khalil Shakir is the highest one out of these with a lower rating. But yeah, well, let's see where we end up. But Cam Jordan, sorry, man. I'm not gonna be giving you a new contract. Everything else, I think was well worth the investment. The mock draft is in the mock draft number 2. I don't think that we actually have a first round pick anymore. So this mock draft is not that exciting for us. Let's just see if anybody's going for Wiley or Riley. Was the player that they suggested we get in the last episode, but I don't see him here. No, he's gonna be a second or third round pick. All right, so we have a superstar X factor quarterback, 23 years old, out of Alabama. That's Bryce Young, number 10 ranked quarterback, top 4. That means he's elite, and that is gonna be a challenge. That's going to be a challenge. And we've got Dalvin Cook as the running back. Superstar X-Factor as well, number 10 ranked. So the running game will be quite tough to stop as well. Oglesby and Toon are the backups. Fullback is Brad Roberts. Wide receiver Justin Jefferson, one of the best wide receivers in the game, number four ranked wide receiver. Pair that with an elite QB and we're gonna be having a lot of troubles stopping their pass play. Laviska Shenault Jr., Deontay Harris, Kevin Spence, Marco Tucker, Bryce Saxon. So the first three, just pure quality right there. Tight end Darren Waller, yak him up, superstar X-Factor as well. Oh my god, fifth ranked tight end, elite as well. So these weapons are quite tough, and the other tight ends are very good as well. Young and pretty highly rated. Left tackle, Christian Darrisaw, 87 overall. Start F3, 25 years old. Wow. Ezra Cleveland, left guard, Edward Ingram behind him. Garrett Bradbury's injured, okay, that's a little bit of a respite. Harry Miller might be the starter, or they're gonna plug in someone else. Right guard, Cody Ford. Madarian Lowe, the backup. Brian O'Neill at right tackle, Devante McKenzie. I know Brian O'Neill from the Snowhawks rebuild. That is a tough O-line. Jesus Christ. What about defense? Oh, nice. Only Danielle Hunter, superstar X-Factor, left edge. Fourth ranked overall. Top 2 percentile. Yeah. Elite. Right there, Marcus Goddard. Behind him, right edge, Leonard Williams. Very, very good. Right edge as well, Jason Harris, Don White. D-tackle, Sebastian Joseph is injured, that's a little bit of a relief. Deion Stevens, 81 rated, normal dev trait. Solid, but not too dangerous, I would say. What are the linebackers? Ah, we've got Justin Hollins there. Former LA Ram. And, yeah, looking good. Looking good, nice to see him again. I always enjoy seeing players that were with me for some time. But yeah, he just didn't make the cut. Brian Asamoah at midlinebacker, Cody Barton, Jacob Phillips. Solid, serviceable midlinebackers right there. Alex Highsmith at right outside linebacker, and Mac Wilson Sr. as the backup. Alex Highsmith has a start F trait. Corners are Rashad Fenton, Cameron Dantzler, Andrew Booth Jr., Ben Barber, and Bradley Winslow. So two pretty solid corners, I would say. What about free safety? Xavier Woods and Lewis Sine. Xavier Woods with a normal def trade out of LA Tech. And strong safety, Julian Love behind him. Kenny Robinson Jr. Julian Love actually looks to be a solid choice. Kicker is Chris Boswell and Kay Kroger. Whew. All right, so what do we do with that information? Apart from silently weep, because they can do it all, right? They have the passing yards, which is not as great, but the rush yards is super high. Turnovers, them number one. Do we stop the outside run? I think we're gonna go with the... Defensive coordinator, sacking will not be an option. Pick it off twice, recover two fumbles, force two plus turnovers. We're gonna go with that. Offensive coordinator, pass for 275 yards. I think that is doable, and don't allow a sack. Yeah, we're gonna be crazy and go with that. Let's see. Okay, so offense has completed training and there are no injuries, especially not for Tyquan Thornton. That would have been bad. Defense, no injuries either. Lots of focus XP, lots of bonus XP. That is great. Let's do the player upgrades, staff upgrades. And then we're going to be heading into the game. Quite a few to take care of. Lucas Finesse, our D tackle, gets an upgrade towards Run Stopper. Base 86 now, block shedding, hit power, play recognition. Tyquan Thornton will get an upgrade. Where do we put that? I think we're going to put that into route running. Just need him to be a bit more precise. Medium route release, short route, spectacular catch. Great. Logan Bruss will get an upgrade towards Agile. At an 81 now, base 79, pass block and strength. David Schultz gets an upgrade towards Agile. Base 80, awareness, pass block, finesse, and run block. Corey Durden, our D tackle back. Those buffs are insane. He's a 73 and a 77 on the pitch. Michael Mayer will get an upgrade. Gonna put that towards possession. Make sure that he holds on to everything. Awareness, impact block, lead block, run block, run block, finesse, short route, speed, and spin move. Okay. That was very positive. We've got 43 staff points to spend. So we're going to be doing that, and we're going to be spending them over here in the player personnel section. And that's all we can spend. All right, here we go. Bryce Young. The final animation that we have to watch in another stadium here, home stadium of the Minnesota Vikings. Bryce Young. What a QB. What a QB. Okay, so we get going at the 28. And we're going to be putting Tyquan Thornton as wide receiver 2 pretty quickly now. Because if we can get him towards a superstar depth rate, that would be fantastic. Let's go the close play action cross. Thornton would be great. Chase would be best. Maybe I'm gonna go with Hopkins if everything else breaks down. All right, good catch. Taken down at the 45. Let's go. Tyquan Thornton, 27 yards. Out of 120 something. That will lead. Good separation and the precise pass, but that is actually what I expect. Akers or Thornton again. Oh, and that is a pick. Jesus. I want to see if we can get a game done without an interception. I really... Wow. Alright, our defense is super on fire. Stopping them with just so few yards gained is fantastic. So let's see. Good catch by Thornton. Went for the safe catch on the right hand side here. And I'm gonna go with the play action double cross. Thornton would be great. Jamar Chase also an option. Off we go. And an injury for Will Lampkin. What is it with those damn interceptions? I honestly have to say, yeah, this is driving me insane. Jesus. Now that's nice, isn't it? Barely getting started here. And we're immediately down. Momentum is in full effect. 14 points. I mean, that is just annoying. Tutu Atwell picks up a few yards here. Will Lampkin injured. We did prepare for injuries. But, come on, man. Let go. Tutu Atwell not going down. I have to acknowledge that. Thornton or Mayer. They're not really separating as well as I would like them to. Eight attempts, five completions. One of the best quarterbacks in the league, that's just not enough. First down. And another injury for an offensive line player, that's David Schultz. Let's try a play action cross stitch short. If we can get him into free space back there, that would be fantastic. Dude. The ball's just hanging in the air. And the secondary players just jump and pluck it away, and that's it. No chance. Wasn't that defense supposed to be a little bit weaker? It's 80-something rated. We're in the 90s, just a quick reminder of what things are looking like. Extremely bad matchups at the moment. And another injury. What's with the defense? Could you please stop breaking my guys? Let's see. Shorter actually has a pretty good route and matchup here, but I did decide to go with Mayer. I think we need to take a look at our offensive line now. There's just too many changes going on here. All right, we've got Jedrick Wills at left tackle. We've got Brian Allen at left guard. Maurice Smith, we've got Logan Bruss at right guard, and we've got Sam Cosmi at right tackle. That's three injuries for starters on the offensive line. Not really what you want to see. All right, the curl. Get it to Mayer if I can. But Thornton is in my eyes as always. But good catch here. And a few more yards for Tyquan Thornton. Second and one, 8 yards to go. Let's go with an inside zone. It's a little bit of running here. And Cam Akers, left hand side. At least we get past the line of scrimmage. We pick up 3 yards. Let's go with a halfback wham. And off we go. There we go. So we drag back one touchdown with our halfback Cam Akers. Question is, can our defense stop them quickly? Actually, no. They're just speeding across the pitch and they score within seconds. Usually I'd say what the hell, but this time I won't. Jamar Chase, Tyquan Thornton. Double coverage. Hardly anything working at the moment. Big passes here. Cross drag. But we need a little bit of space out the back there. So shorter or Thornton. Alright, good catch. Good catch here. Tyquan Thornton, 92 out of 125 yards. If we get that, we have another superstar on our hands. And that is, of course, what we want to achieve. Mayer, Shakir, or Chase. And this is going to be a tough game. 17 and 12, Lamar Jackson. Should be doing better. It's always the fumbles. It's just so annoying. Can't even begin to tell you. Dragging forward, Michael Mayer. Let's try a cross drag as we hit the 2-minute warning now. This might be the worst start to a game that we've had in quite a while. So looking for Thornton here, but not opening up. Meyer does a great job of picking up 9 yards here. Shakir or Meyer, a lot of tight end action at the moment. There we go, into the end zone as Williams picks up an injury for the Vikings. Come on, and all right, defense stops them. That is the break we needed. Now, no interceptions, no silly stuff. Just focused gameplay. Justin Shorter, a former Florida Gator. Out onto the right-hand side. Thornton again. It's a very tough matchup at the moment. Oh. What the hell? What the hell happened? No, seriously. What the hell happened? Thornton gets space and the ball comes along. And okay, yes, too high, but could have gone for that, in my opinion. Digging our own grave. Over and over and over and over. Could really, I think you're insane here. That is just such a bad throw. Get it. Jesus Christ, man. And again, running into each other like the absolute morons that they are. Could go insane here, man. I mean, this is it, right? 14 points behind in the first half. Oh, do catch the ball, but it's absolutely useless. 4th and 10. As we end the first half, behind by 14 points. Gotta let that sink in. Alright, what do we do? Okay, gonna throw it medium. Need to get that going. It's just absolutely infuriating. Looked like we were able to stop them for a while. Then we just give them ball back the ball again. So quickly. Yards. Harris. Looks so small. And off we go. Alright, so at least we limit them here. With a slot cross here. Tutu Atwell, Michael Mayer, but maybe we can get Jamar Chase into the backfield here. Yes, we can. Almost looked like another interception. We had four interceptions. And we've got four touchdowns against us. Coincidence? I think not. Freaking hell. I mean, I don't want to go towards a running play again because I have such a good quarterback. How can that be? How can it be that this quarterback is this bad at the moment? And I swear to God, some choices aren't great. Those are mine. But then again, some of them are exactly on target and the ball just goes super wide. For instance, the one for Tyquan Thornton or the one just now. I don't know, man. I didn't want to put him on a zig. Come on. Yeah, why not? One on another pick. I want to have 6 picks in a game, please. I don't get it. 20 more yards are needed here. This is just a little bit of a whatever. Just going to do it myself. Let's go with the slip screen. The defense is tough. Way tougher than the overall suggested. And that was useless. Absolutely useless. Only a short pickup here, 6 yards. Tyquan Thornton. How many yards do we have for him now? 11 more. Let's quickly get this going. Oh, Jesus. Not happening. Not happening. Third quarter is over. 38 offensive snaps. And hardly anything to count for it. because those two touchdowns are nice, but we're not going to win. Okay, so we got the target for Tyquan Thornton. That is good. Now let's see that we get touchdowns. Jamar Chase, Thornton, shorter on the most direct route. And that's out of bounds. Not really happening at the moment. What about this next spot here? Still looking for Jamar Chase. Actually, he only is a decoy. Is that a pass interference? Let's go with the verticals. Right far end of the end zone here for Jamar Chase. Everybody tired. Everybody just so tired. And we flip the ball, throw it around. I don't know what we're doing anymore. I think everybody's super tired, which is why I've got a lot of plays with Bryce and Hopkins as my tight end. I have to go for Jamar Chase here though. Can't catch the ball. Not happening. Just not happening. And I mean, kudos to our defense because they're really holding us in the game. But we're not going to win anything like this. It's always double coverage. It's always double coverage. I'm not able to hold onto the ball. Barely 50% pass completion ratings. There we go. Only my tight end is an option. He's taken down so quickly. Southeast corner run again, Jamar Chase. Tired. Secure catch. Fourth and five. Fourth and five, and we're absolutely struggling. We had a few very good games, so we really have to acknowledge that. Nope. I'm a bit speechless, to be honest, at how little of a chance we're having at the moment. So it really feels like there's just no way. Whenever I connect, there's a defender there. Whenever whenever somebody gets free, it's a struggle. And let's see. Come on, Jamar. Why can we not? Six interceptions and an injury for Lamar Jackson. Run play was non-existent. Receiving was great. Tyquan Thornton was very good. We'll have to leave it at that. Michael Mayer was great as well. Blocking was abhorrent. Yeah. it's just not much more to say here. Defense did a good job. I have to acknowledge that, but offense was woeful. It's just so bad. It's absolutely bad. I told coach before the game to have his popcorn ready because I knew Lamar and I were going to put on a show. Everything is clicking for us and it feels like we can't be stopped. Superstardom, Tyquan Thornton now has superstar death trait. That is positive. Alright, that is the positive of this episode. Didn't score 1000 XP. Alright, that is good. I think the breakout player is not gonna happen. Yeah. Target was 175, we didn't get that, never mind. He got the superstar, that was important for me. And I really don't want to look at the injuries. I really don't want to look there. Okay, so Jalen Ramsey has a broken thumb. He's going to be out for 3 weeks. That is terrible. Our CB1 and Emil Ekiyor has a dislocated elbow, will be out for 4 weeks. Okay. That at least is not the bad news that I was fearing, because I was fearing that Lamar Jackson would be injured, which luckily he's not. But we do have a superstar here at wide receiver now, and we're going to be putting Tyquan Thornton as wide receiver 2 permanently. Justin Shorter, wide receiver 3. And Tutu Atwell is going to stay where he is. Wan'Dale Robinson as well, Van Jefferson as well. And yeah, we're going to have to cover the injury for Emil Ekiyor. Going to be missing him, of course. But I think Logan Bruss will be able to cover that adequately. What about that corner? Yeah, we're down to one good corner again. And then we have solid ones. Not happy about this, of course, but we're gonna have to make do. This will show the mettle of the team, right? Because any team can dominate with the best players around, and we have to show that we can be good despite not having the best players at every position. So I'm really torn. One hand side, I'm happy at getting the superstar dev trade for Tyquan Thornton. On the other hand, I'm just super disappointed about our second loss this season. We just started so well. And yeah, but two really good opponents now. Next week, it's gonna be the Bears, then the 49ers. And then it's not gonna be easier. It's gonna be the Bills away, the Patriots at home. Cooper Kupp joined the Patriots, so we're gonna be seeing him again. And if we wanna get to the Super Bowl, we will have to play a lot better than this, because this is a downward curve now. That's 3 points and that's 14 points. So we will need to stop this. We need to start winning again. Return to winning ways. And then I think we should be fine at the mid-season mark. Hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, please drop me a like and subscribe. And as always, thank you for watching and see you next time.